like this could happen in America. America.
Earlier this afternoon, Donald Trump was arraigned on 34 felony counts of falsifying business records in the first degree.
Never thought it could happen.
34 false statements made to cover up other crimes. Crimes relating to the 2016 election.
The only crime that I have committed is to fearlessly defend our nation from those who seek to destroy it.
Trump.
Or death.
He is our president.
Donald Trump and others agreed in 2015 to a catch and kill scheme, a scheme to buy and suppress negative information to help Mr. Trump's chance of winning the election.
Our country is going to hell.
It's a total political prosecution. It's a dirty political prosecution.
America first!
As part of this scheme, Donald Trump and others made three payments to people who claim to have negative information about Mr. Trump.
The allegations involve three separate payments, one to porn actor Stormy Daniels, one to Playboy model Karen McDougal, and a third to a doorman at Trump Tower.
The doorman was stationed here. He claimed Trump may have fathered a love child.
One of the three people that they paid to keep quiet was a woman named Stormy Daniels. Less than 2 weeks before the presidential election, Michael Cohen wired $130,000 to Stormy Daniels' lawyer. That payment was to hide damaging information from the voting public. And in order to get Michael Cohen his money back, they planned to mischaracterize the repayments to Mr. Cohen as income. Mr. Trump said that he was paying Mr. Cohen for legal services. This simply was not true.
Virtually everybody that has looked at this case say there is no crime.
The participant scheme was illegal. The scheme violated New York election law. The $130,000 wire payment exceeded the federal campaign contribution cap, and the false statements violated New York law.
This is not the right thing to do.
Everyone stands equal before the law. No amount of money and no amount of power changes that enduring American principle.
There is no case. There's no case. With all of this being said, I have no doubt we will make America great again. God bless you and God bless America. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
There's a rich irony, isn't there, in like the fact that his campaign began with lock her up and then this could be the end point of it. But as I think about this, I can't see a good outcome. Like, if he's acquitted, then, well, this was all a gotcha, it was like a political thing, it was just ridiculous, and he's a victim. And if he's convicted, kind of same argument, right? Mm-hmm. It's the whole thing can't be trusted. So is there a way out of this that doesn't involve America on fire?
I don't think so. And it's... Yeah, it's interesting that this is a man that survived two impeachments. Yeah. He was acquitted from two impeachments, and he seems to be Teflon.
Yeah.
And this just galvanises supporters and people wanting to, you know, contribute to his campaign. Since he was indicted, $10 million has been raised for his campaign.
But so, what do you do, though? Because if he has broken the law, and I think part of the argument here is maybe the case isn't absolutely watertight, and that could be a problem, but if he has broken the law, you can't just not prosecute someone because people might be upset about it. So I actually don't know. Maybe it's just symptomatic, right? America's worked itself into this position where there are no ways through.
Yeah, the chat after the court appearance did feel a lot like a campaign launch, though, didn't it?
Totally.